Hey, what's up? It's Frank here from DataDriven.tv, the podcast where we explore the emerging fields of data science, machine learning, and artificial intelligence. If you like to think of data as the new oil, you could consider us Car Talk. So I'm here at a super secret gathering of what we call at Microsoft AI ambassadors. I'm decked out in my Data is Beautiful t-shirt. And with me is a bunch of folks also from the D.C. Metro.
So, I'm Carrie.
Hi, I'm Rick.
And that's Pav. We used to work together.
Hi, I'm Smree.
And she's a huge Phillies fan, right?
Oh, that's a lie.
So we're here. So I thought this was like a super secret squirrel event. So what is the AI Ambassador Program exactly?
So Microsoft is trying to gather a cohesive message around artificial intelligence as we talk to our customers about it. Because there's clearly, and I think all of us would agree, that robots are not coming to take over your job, right? Maybe they're taking away some really mundane parts of it. But let's just say there's a lot of stuff being thrown at you all the time, and AI can help you manage that. So I think we're here to figure out how to talk about it, how to deliver that message, how to be ethical about it. That's a big one. And so when we walk away, we're going to be, we're going to be so smart. It's going to be amazing.
It'll be scary smart, right?
So, I don't know. So it's only 2 days, though. We're here at the welcome reception in
Bellevue.
Yeah. I was going to say, they call it Seattle. It's not Seattle. And just a little fun fact, I was here for the Snowmageddon of Seattle, and it's all ice. So it's really hard to walk on the sidewalks. It's pretty bad.
Yeah, and it's treacherous. There's a lot of hills here.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
You never realize it. Like, yeah.
It's yeah, like if you have a car, it's not stopping. That's it, yeah. So there you go.
Cool. You know, I totally agree. I think there will be an impact on jobs longer term. But in the near term, I think ethics is probably going to be the biggest concern. Issues of bias. You know, because if you have an algorithm that says this person's more likely to pay their cell phone bill late,
I was planning on working on
no one's going to get killed for that. Right? But if you have algorithms that start determining where police presences are going to be amped up and when they're not, or who's going to get paroled and who's not, that's a serious concern over people's lives. And you have to really, I think, be thoughtful in addressing the bias in there.
Yeah.
You know.
Well, and also there's unintentional biases.
Right.
How many decision trees have ever been made or rules have been created that once you actually start using it and people start interacting with it, that all of a sudden you have a bias that you didn't even model for, you didn't even predict, wasn't even in there. I think I'll bring this up. Your viewers may not like me about it, but Facebook was not designed to be a Russian intelligence to do the election, right? Back in the day, all it was a Facebook for college kids. And as the years have gone on, as the technology has evolved, it's gone in directions no one could have predicted in 2006.
Well, not even that, but Facebook has been busted with running experiments on users to control their moods.
Well, and also
making people depressed and making them like,
yeah.
So there's like, that is a huge attack surface for anyone.
Well, did you also, this was in our training, was that...
Also, there was like super secret training before this?
Super secret.
Oh, wow.
But it's
double
not,
secret, triple.
But it's available on the internet. It's totally free. Anybody can find it. But you know how it has to percolate to the top.
Yeah,
find it. Facebook owns the patent to help to any advertiser decide whether or not a consumer is worthy of a product. So say a bank, it wants to lend you money and they want to determine your credit worthiness. Facebook owns the patent so that they can look at the credit worthiness of all the people in your network, and if the people in your network have bad credit, that company may decide not to give you a loan.
That's crazy, and
what's the story? When you're dealing with banking, there's usually some kind of regulation footprint. Is there any regulation around that yet, or that's so new they have to cut off?
I don't think it was actually patented by Facebook in 2015. It's now 2019,
wow.
And I think it was an advertising patent
a whole lot
that
got
used
for.
So this is where I'm saying we make a product for one purpose, and then it goes down this whole other thread that nobody ever thought, why would that ever happen?
Right, right.
And so that was 4 years ago, but they own the patent on it, and banks have been using it to deny people loans.
That's crazy. I think we just really scratched the surface of this. And one of the things that's a common theme in our show is we talk about the law of unintended consequences.
Why am I going?
You know, and I think if anything, we see social media and Facebook and all that as kind of that being writ large.
Yeah,
you know,
absolutely. Unintended consequences from well-intentioned design.
Right, right, right.
I mean, you know, but do you have an example you'd like to share
for AI? I got one story.
Cool.
Well, okay, my favorite one.
Yeah.
So I live in Atlanta, so I'm all about the CDC.
Uh-huh.
So I always get like updates about Zika and Ebola and dengue and like all the terrible, distressing things, right? But like the positive of this is that I was reading how AI is involved in like biomedical stuff. And the biggest thing that I think is most interesting is like back in the day, epidemiologists would have to wait to study pathogens like a month after the body is dead and things like that. And so now we instead put a sensor in mosquitoes and study large, like thousands of mosquitoes and like figure out where they breed to get the ones that are infected with disease because they've been bit by some, I know it's morbid,
that's crazy.
I'm sorry.
No, but it's bit
by some sort of animal. And then through the sensor, we can capture their genetic information.
Interesting.
Yeah.
And then we study that. And so before, this process would take a month for epidemiologists.
Wow.
Now, because of AI, it takes 12 hours. 12 hours is the last thing I read as far as speed. To me, that's really cool because I used to be interested in bio. So.
Wow. What's really interesting is that there was a recent project where DeepMind, I know they're from a different company, but DeepMind did a project where they won some kind of figuring out protein folding sequences.
Yeah.
They beat out like Pfizer, Glaxo, all those big names. They beat it out because the AI figured it out. Like on its own, like they used an RL, reinforcement learning, and it's just like, that's pretty crazy. Like I looked at that and I was like, they were not biologists, they were not epidemiologists, they were not.
It's like studying experience,
right?
And like deep neural networks,
right? They just set the bot on it, and the bot kind of chewed through it.
Yeah,
that's
what I'm super excited about.
That was really cool.
And I hope they teach me about it because I don't know about what I just talked about, and I want to learn about it.
So you don't know about Siraj Raval yet?
Just no.
I'll send you a link to his YouTube channel.
Send me.
That guy is on fire.
Okay.
Yeah,
I want to learn about what I just talked about.
Yeah.
I'm interested in the policy side. Like, I like the policy side of it. One of the stories that stuck out to me the most from last year was in South Korea, a Roomba ripped off a lady's hair. And, yeah, it was as simple as in South Korea, there's sometimes, you know, foam mats that they sleep on the floor. Closer to the floor, and the Roomba just misidentified her hair as the breed because they didn't know what to look for. So, you know, having diversity in tech would have, you know, sort of mitigated that issue. It would have picked that up earlier, right?
Right, or it would have flagged it as, you know, if I'm...
So it would have known what to expect.
Right.
The machine was performing its purpose, right?
Right, right, right.
And it was just an unawareness of the different cultures at play, so...
Right.
It was interesting, yeah.
That's actually a good point, because you think about these models that get deployed... And,
they do their jobs really well.
Well, they're trained on what they know,
yeah.
Right? So so then you put them somewhere else where the rules are a little different.
Mm-hmm.
Like I had this discussion with somebody that it's not a coincidence. All the test bed areas for self-driving cars are in areas without snow.
Mm-hmm.
Right? The Bay Area,
Las Vegas,
Phoenix, right? Because those things cannot see the road when there's snow, where they can't see the lines. So it's like that's, you know... probably not an accident.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. That reminds me of, like, I read this thing when it was, like, trying to learn AI speech and learning and knowledge. It's, like, identify a dog by looking at all these pictures. But if you define a dog with an animal that has four legs, maybe it'll pick up the dog. But what if it's a three-legged dog and got injured and it doesn't pick up the dog?
Right, right. And you
so
get into
that's
some...
when you get those errors.
Yep.
And
there,
so,
yep.
so sad.
There's an example
sad.
Of that where they were trying to differentiate between dogs and foxes.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
a lot of the foxes were just in the wind. Or in the snow, right? And
so no, that was wolves.
It was, I think between it was, I think it was snow foxes. But
was
it might have been wolves. You're right.
I
think
yeah,
it was one
that.
Of the,
I brought my
they were trying to teach it to differentiate between a dog and a wolf. And the pictures they used for the wolf or the fox always tended to be with snowy backgrounds. So the algorithm just picked up on the snowy background and used that as opposed to the features of the different animals and the species. So that's called like the black box, right? The black box of AI. So
right.
you don't really know what's going on in the algorithm, you just know that it works.
Right. That's what I'm hoping they'll talk about is explainable AI, which is kind of like this frontier of if the black box, you can shed some light into what's going on in there.
And actually, Microsoft was, that was, I think, part of the training leading up to this, mm-hmm. was not...
the super secret stuff.
The super secret stuff. Not available on Netflix. But it was basically that it has to be transparent.
Right.
So how it's working has to be transparent. Because if you, like in the old neural networks, it kind of, they just... threw it in,
right.
and they weren't really sure how it was making those decisions,
right.
how it was making the correlations. I think one of the stories in our super secret training was about how they threw some information into a neural network box, and it came out that having asthma is good for pneumonia. Having a heart condition is good for pneumonia. What the correlation was is that if you have asthma, you probably have a pulmonologist on call, and you're very, very sensitive to breathing problems, so should something go wrong, you're more likely to catch pneumonia than people without asthma who don't maybe not paying attention.
Right.
So, but the way that the AI figured out the data was that if you have asthma, you have a very low chance of pneumonia. Needless, and so they couldn't figure out how it was doing it. So
it's like that logical fallacy of wherever you see a fire truck, there's a fire. So if you ban fire trucks, fires won't be a problem. It's kind of like that. Like it's like you can understand from that point of view, but it's totally wrong.
Right. Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. So transparent AI, how is it making decisions? How
right.
are you doing? That's going to be a.
Yeah.
I don't know how you do it. Yeah. Well.
It'll be interesting to see. It'll be interesting to see. All right, so you stay tuned. We'll definitely have, until they come and shut me down, if, in case this is super secret.
Super.
Super duper secret. You have a great day.
You too.